Hello children, welcome back to chemistry session. In last session we discussed about empirical formula and for molecular formula. In today's session we are going to talk about stoichiometry and stoichiometric calculations.
Stoichiometry and stoichiometric calculations.
Let us start today's session. What is meant by stoichiometry? Stoichiometry means the word stoichiometry is derived from Greek language. Here, the word itself tells about stoichio means element and metry means measurement. Stoichiometry means the word itself tells about element measurement, that means calculation of amounts of reactants and products in the given chemical equation. That is called stoichiometry. So stoichiometry involves calculation of amounts of reactants and products in the given chemical equation. For example, let us consider the equation like N2 plus O2 is raised to 2NO. It's a stoichiometric equation, or it's a balanced chemical equation. Here, nitrogen gas and oxygen gas react together, which forms NO, nitric oxide gas. We can express in such a way that in terms of moles, stoichiometry involves in terms of moles and in terms of molecules and in terms of molecular mass and in terms of volume of the gases. So in four ways we can explain or we can express stoichiometric calculation. So stoichiometric calculation involves four types. One is in terms of moles, in terms of molecules, in terms of molecular mass or molar mass, and in terms of gaseous volume. Let's see those. Here in terms of moles, here 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 1 mole of oxygen to form 2 moles of nitric oxide. Here 1, 1, 1 are called stoichiometric coefficients. So this tells about in terms of mole, 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 1 mole of oxygen, produce 2 moles of ammonia, 2 moles of nitric oxide, NOS. This is in terms of moles. In terms of molecules, 1 molecule of nitrogen reacts with 1 molecule of oxygen, produce 2 molecules of nitric oxide. This is in terms of molecules. And in terms of molar mass of nitrogen is 28 grams. 28 grams of nitrogen reacts with molar mass of oxygen is 32 grams. 32 grams of oxygen to produce molar mass of nitric oxide. Nitrogen atomic mass 17, oxygen 18 plus oxygen 16, children. 16 plus 17, how much? 33 grams. Here 2 moles are there, so 2 moles means 2 into 33 is equal to 66 grams of nitric oxide. In terms of molar mass, 28 grams of nitrogen reacts with 32 grams of oxygen to produce 66 grams of nitric oxide. Nitric oxide means NO. This is in terms of molar mass. Next, in terms of volume, 22.7 liter of nitrogen reacts with 22.7 7 liter of oxygen produce 2 into 22.7 liter of nitric oxide. Remember, children, here at stable condition, 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.7 liter volume, that is constant, children. At STP means standard temperature and pressure. So at STP conditions, the value of the temperature is 0 degree Celsius or 273.15 Kelvin. Temperature is 0 degree Celsius or 273.15 Kelvin. Pressure is equal to 1 atmosphere. An atmosphere of 760 torr, that is equal to 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. At STP condition, pressure value is 1 atmosphere or 760 torr or 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. So at STP condition, the volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas is equal to 22.7 liter. 22.7 liter or 22,700 cubic centimeter. This is the volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at STP condition. So here we express the given chemical equation in terms of mole, in terms of molecule, and in terms of molar mass, and in terms of volume. So stoichiometric calculations involves these 4 types: number of moles, terms of moles, in terms of molecules, and molar mass, and volume. So stoichiometry means calculations involving amount of reactants and products in a given chemical equation. If you want to find out the amount of reactants and products in a given chemical equation, first we have to consider stoichiometric equation. Stoichiometric equation means a balanced chemical equation. Here N2 plus O2 is ratio to NO. This is a balanced chemical equation of formation of nitric oxide from nitrogen and oxygen. Here 1, 1, 2 are called stoichiometric coefficients. Stoichiometric coefficients means amounts of reactants and products in the given chemical equation. This is called stoichiometry or stoichiometric calculations. Next, let us talk about limiting reagent or limiting reactant. Limiting reagent is a part of stoichiometric calculation. Let us see limiting reagent. Let's see what is meant by limiting reagent or limiting reactant. We have observed many chemical reactions in our day-to-day life, or sometimes we observe chemical reaction taking place in the laboratories, industries, and factories. In all the times, many times, the amounts of reactants are may not be in the required proportion. Sometimes one of the reactant may be in excess and another reactant may be in less quantity. So the reactant which is present in excess amount, the reactant is called as excess reagent, and the one which is in less quantity than requirement, then it is called limiting reagent. So limiting reagent or limiting reactant can be defined in such a way that the reactant or the reagent which is present in the less quantity for the requirement, and the reactant which is present in the less quantity, that alters the formation of product in the given chemical reaction. That reagent is called limiting reagent or limiting reactant. I'm repeating, children. Limiting reactant or limiting reagent can be defined in such a way that the reactant or the reagent, one which is present in the less quantity or less amount than requirement, and the reactant which is present in the less quantity, which alter the formation of the product. And what are the
whatever be the other reactant is present. That reactant or the reagent is called as limiting reagent or limiting reactant. This is the definition of limiting reagent or limiting reactant, children. And let us do some problems based on stoichiometric calculations and limiting reactant.
Let's say these two problems, children. These two problems are examples of stoichiometric calculations. Here, first problem: 10 volume of hydrogen reacts with 5 volumes of oxygen, comma, how many volumes of water will be formed? Here they given in terms of volumes. If you want to solve the problem, first let us write stoichiometric equation of formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen. Stoichiometric equation is 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. This is the stoichiometric equation of formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen. 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. Here they have given 10 volume of hydrogen. So 10 volume of hydrogen is, let us consider the stoichiometric coefficients is in terms of volume. Here 2 volumes of hydrogen is reacts with 1 volume of hydrogen, which produces 2 volume of water. So we have considered the stoichiometric coefficient in terms of volume children. According to the given problem, 10 volume of hydrogen. 10 volume of hydrogen is reacts with 5 volume of oxygen. 5 volume of oxygen. Then how many moles of water vapor would be formed? Then x moles of water vapor would be formed. We don't know because we have to calculate the how many moles of water vapor would be formed. Then 10 volume of hydrogen reacts with 5 volume of oxygen. Let us compare the standard equation. Let us consider the standard equation here. Our stoichiometric equation is 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. This equation tells about 2 volume of hydrogen reacts with 1 volume of oxygen. That means volume of hydrogen is twice to that of volume of oxygen. Then it produces 2 volume of water vapor. Here in the problem they have given 10 volume of hydrogen. 10 volume of hydrogen is reacting with 5 volume of oxygen. That means volume of hydrogen is twice to that of volume of oxygen. Then how many volume of water would be formed? That is equal to 10 volume. 10 volume of water vapor. Because in the above equation, volume of hydrogen is 5 to that of volume of oxygen. In the given data, volume of hydrogen, that is 10 volume of hydrogen, is reacting with volume of oxygen. That is, volume of hydrogen is twice to that of volume of oxygen. Then which forms 2 molecules of water, that means 10 volume of water vapor. This is the way we have to solve the problem. So the answer for first problem is 10 volume of water vapor. In the second problem, how many moles of methane are required to produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide? First, let us write stoichiometric equation. We have to know the formula of methane. Methane formula CH4. CH4 is a gas, methane. How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide? Combustion of methane. Combustion means when any compound or any substance reacts with oxygen, which produces carbon dioxide and water vapor. These two are gases. You have to represent upward aroma on product side. Here CH4 is a methane gas which reacts with oxygen gas to form carbon dioxide and water vapor. We have to verify the equation whether it is a balanced equation or not. It's not a balanced equation because there are two oxygen atoms on the RHS side. On RHS side, 2 plus 1, 3 oxygen atoms are present. So we have to balance the equation. For balancing equation, let us write 2 here. 2 before the oxygen. Then number of oxygen atoms on LHS side is 4. On LHS side 2 here, and let us write 2 here. Here 2 oxygen atoms. Here 2. 2 plus 2, 4 oxygen atoms.
Next carbon atom, 1. 1 carbon atom. Number of hydrogen atom, 2 are 4. On LHS side. Now LHS side, 4. So it's a stoichiometric equation. That is, 1 CH4 plus 2 O2 gives rise to 1 CO2 plus 2H2O. Here, 1 comma, 2 comma, 1 comma, 2 are stoichiometric coefficients of reactants and products. What you have to find here? How many moles of methane are required to produce 20 grams of carbon dioxide? So here they have given how many moles of methane. Here methane is on reactant side. Here 1 mole of methane, because their stoichiometric coefficient is 1. So 1 mole of methane is producing carbon dioxide. 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Molar mass of carbon dioxide is 44 grams in mass. 44 grams of carbon dioxide. Because molecular mass and molar mass of carbon dioxide calculated in such a way that carbon 12, O2 32 plus 12, 44 grams. This is the way we have to find out molar mass of a given molecule. So 1 mole of methane produce 44 grams of carbon dioxide. What we have to find? How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide? We want 22 grams of carbon dioxide. Then, how many moles of methane we require? We don't know. Let us consider x mole of methane. X mole of methane required for 22 grams of carbon dioxide. Do cross multiplication. Then, x is equal to 44 by 22. 44 by 22 means is equal to x moles of methane is equal to 22 by 44 is equal to 22 by 44. 22 by 44 means 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means 0.5 mole. 0.5 mole of methane required to produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide. Let us see the problem again. First, we have to consider stoichiometric equation, that is CH4 plus 2O2 gives rise to CO2 plus 2H2O. This equation tells about 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. In the problem they have given, how many moles of methane required to produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide? So, according to this stoichiometric equation, 1 mole of methane produce, molar mass of carbon dioxide is 44 grams. 44 grams of carbon dioxide. Then, how many moles of methane produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide? 0.5 moles. 0.5 mole of methane produce 22 grams of carbon dioxide. Because 1 mole gives 44 grams. 0.5 mole gives 22 grams of carbon dioxide. This is the way we have to find out problems given in the stoichiometric calculations. Let us see one more problem, children. This problem is based on the limiting reaction. We have already discussed the definition of limiting reaction. Limiting reaction means the reaction which is present in the less quantity than requirement, which decides the formation of product, is called limiting reagent or limiting reactor. Let's see the problem. Calculate the mass of ammonia produced if 2 into 10 kilograms of nitrogen reacts with 1 into 10 kilograms of hydrogen. Find out the limiting reagent here and follow the given equation. N2 plus H2 gives rise to 2NH3. So we have to calculate mass of ammonia, and they have given mass of nitrogen is 2 into 10 kilograms and mass of hydrogen is 1 into 10 kilograms. We have to convert mass of nitrogen and hydrogen into number of moles. Let us start the problem. First, we have to convert masses of reactants into number of moles. So, number of moles of nitrogen. Number of moles of nitrogen, formula N is equal to mass of nitrogen. Here we have given nitrogen, any substance, mass of nitrogen by molar mass. Molar mass of substance. A substance is nitrogen. So number of moles divided by small n. Small n is equal to mass of nitrogen by molar mass of nitrogen. Mass of nitrogen is 2 × 10³ by molar mass of nitrogen is 28 grams because N2 molecule. Molar mass 28 grams. Grams gram get cancelled. Number of moles of nitrogen is equal to. If you simplify the value, you will get 0.0714 × 10³ mol. So 0.0714 × 10³ mol is the number of moles of nitrogen. Next, let us calculate number of moles of hydrogen. Number of moles of hydrogen is equal to same formula. Number of moles is equal to mass of substance by molar mass of substance. Small n is equal to mass of hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen by molar mass of hydrogen. Mass of hydrogen 1 × 10³ grams by molar mass of hydrogen is 2 grams. The gram gram get cancelled. Then n is equal to 1/2 value is 0.5 × 10³ mol. This is the number of moles of hydrogen. Why we have to find out number of moles of reactant reaction? Because we must follow this stoichiometric equation. Because we have to follow this equation. According to the equation, we have to find out mass of ammonia produced here. The equation is N2 plus H2 with respect to 2 H2. According to the equation, 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 1 mole of hydrogen, produce 2 moles of ammonia. Here 1, 1, 2 are stoichiometric coefficients. We have discussed earlier, children. Here 1, 1, 2 are stoichiometric coefficients of reactants and products. Here 1 mole of nitrogen is reacts with 1 mole of hydrogen to produce 2 moles of ammonia. So 1 mole of nitrogen is reacting with 1 mole of hydrogen. Then according to the problem, 0.0714 × 10³ moles of nitrogen. 0.0714 × 10³ moles of nitrogen is reacting with X moles of hydrogen. X moles of hydrogen, because we are comparing, we are using the equation given here. According to the equation, 1 mole of nitrogen is reacting with 1 mole of hydrogen, and 0.0714 mole of nitrogen is reacting with X moles of nitrogen. Here X value is 0.0714 mole of hydrogen. So number of moles of hydrogen required is 0.0714 mole of hydrogen required. But in the problem, we have given 0.5 × 10³. Here 0.0714 × 10³ moles of hydrogen. This amount of hydrogen is required for the reaction as taking place with nitrogen and hydrogen. But in the problem, we have given 0.5 × 10³ moles of hydrogen. So this is more than requirement. That's why in this reaction, hydrogen is excess reagent. Hydrogen is excess reagent, and other one, that is nitrogen, is limiting reagent. This reaction, hydrogen is excess reagent because which is present more than its requirement. Hydrogen is limiting reagent. Nitrogen is present in less amount. This nitrogen alters the formation of ammonia, because formation of the product of the given chemical reaction is based on the limiting reagent. We have seen the definition of limiting reagent in such a way that the reagent which is present in less quantity than its requirement and which alters the formation of the product. And whatever be the other reactant is present. So the formation of ammonia is completely based on the amount of limiting reagent. So in this reaction, limiting reagent is nitrogen. Now let us find out mass of ammonia produced here. So mass of ammonia produced here, we already mentioned the same equation. N2 plus H2 equals H2O. According to the equation, 1 mole of nitrogen produced 2 moles of ammonia. Same equation will be. 1 mole of nitrogen produced how many moles of ammonia? 2 moles of ammonia. Then 0.0714 into 10 cube mole of nitrogen produced. 0.0714 into 10 cube mole of nitrogen produced. X moles of ammonia. X moles of ammonia. We have to find out here X value. Do cross multiplication. Then X is equal to, we want X value children. X is go here. Then 0.0714 into 2 into 10 cube. X will go here, 2 will go there. So 2 into 0.0714 into 10 cube is equal to 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 7s are 14. So 0.1428 into 10 cube. 0.1428 into 10 cube mole of ammonia. 10 cube mole of ammonia produced. According to the given equation, 1 mole of nitrogen produced 2 moles of ammonia. Similarly, 0.0714 into 10 cube moles of nitrogen produced 0.1428 into 10 cube mole of ammonia produced. We have to convert number of moles of ammonia into gram. Let us see the formula here. Number of moles is equal to mass by molar mass. We have written here. We want mass of ammonia. How can you find out mass of ammonia? Mass of ammonia is equal to mass of ammonia is equal to number of moles, small n. Number of moles of ammonia into smaller mass of ammonia. Here number of moles of ammonia is 0.1428. 0.1428 into 10 cube and molar mass of ammonia 17 into 28 because ammonia formula is NH3, nitrogen 14, hydrogen is 3 hydrogen atom 17. 17 grams is the molar mass of ammonia and number of moles of ammonia we calculated here 0.1428 into 10 cube. That is multiplication, right? 0.1428 into 17 into 28. If you simplify this, you will get, if you simplify this, you will get 0.43. 0.43 into 10 cube gram. This is the mass of ammonia produced. 0.43 into 10 cube grams. Let's see the problem sugar. Here, they have given the masses of nitrogen and hydrogen in grams. We have to convert masses of reactants into number of moles. Number of moles formula, mass of the substance and molar mass of the substance. So we got here number of moles of nitrogen, similarly number of moles of hydrogen. And here they have given the equation N2 plus H2O equals NH3. We have to follow the equation. According to the equation, 1 mole of nitrogen is reacting with 1 mole of hydrogen. Then 0.0714 into 10 cube moles of nitrogen reacts with X moles of hydrogen. Then X value is 0.0714 into 10 cube moles of hydrogen. That moles of hydrogen is required. But in the problem we got 0.5 into 10 cube moles of hydrogen, which is required than, which is more than our requirement. So that in this reaction hydrogen is excess reagent, nitrogen is limiting reagent, and this limiting reagent alters the formation of ammonia produced here. So that we should consider the equation again. one mole of hydrogen produce two moles of ammonia, then 0.0714 under the power of 3 moles of hydrogen produce x moles of ammonia. If we do cross multiplication, we got here 0.1428 into 10 cube moles of ammonia. We have to convert number of moles of ammonia into mass. We have the formula number of moles is equal to mass by molar mass. We want mass here. Then mass is equal to number of moles into molar mass. Number of moles of ammonia 0.1428 into 10 cube into molar mass of ammonia 17. If you simplify that, you will get 2.43 into 10 cube grams of ammonia. So in the problem, 2.43 into 10 cube grams of ammonia produced. And what is limiting reagent here? Limiting reagent is nitrogen. And what is excess reagent here? Excess reagent is hydrogen. This is the way we have to do the problems based on stoichiometric calculations and limiting reagent children. This is today's session. I hope you understand today's session. We'll meet you in next session. Thank you, children.